Hey, hey, that's not bad. So this whole EU free trade debacle, it's been going on for 5 long years. Basically, if we accepted their terms, we'd have to rename locally produced European-y sounding things like feta, mozzarella, parmesan and prosecco, which totally ignores Australia's proud European heritage. This country was built on titans like the Imbruglias, the Lapalias or the Giannopolises.
What?
But if Donald Trump's art of the deal has taught me anything, which it has not, it's that sometimes compromise is needed to reach an agreement. So why don't we embrace some product name changes?
Like what?
Feta could become Fetamine, Steve Price.
What? There
we
go.
We could shorten mozzarella to mozza. Gruyere could become as Aussie. It could be Gruyere Na. And for the obvious choice for Prosecco, Mum's Truth Serum.
I feel attacked. I feel attacked.
Look, a free trade deal with the EU would be handy, as they have 446 million people and a market value of about 24 trillion bucks. So when talks start next year, perhaps instead of a suit, our trade minister, Don Farrell, could consider wearing a provocative mankini. Perhaps our very Italian-sounding prime minister, Anthony Albanese, could attend dressed as a local that only they would understand. Or, and I don't say this lightly, we threaten to turn off the Tim Tam tap.
What?
I'm being serious.
No,
no Australian lamb, no Tim Tam slams.
Oh.
Either that or we'll turn Barcelona into the new Bali. That is a threat.
Oh,
wow, gosh. Thank you.
Brilliant.
Thank you, guys. If I did all that and didn't get an applause, yeah. I was going to be shattered.
Does that thing work for everyone? Or is it only, can only you do
that? Do you
the...
want to have a go?
I could... All right, I'll try...
Oh, wow, that's pretty
Who
good.
Who needs Gwyneth's gong when you've got the whip?
Yeah, I'm actually selling that for $23,000 on my website, if you want to buy it.
Is it gold-plated?
It's gold-plated, absolutely.
So yeah. When do you think the negotiations will resume with Don Farrell, do you think?
That's a terrific question, Steve Price, and I'm very glad you asked me. Let me just check. What was that? Oh, Steve's being annoying. OK. let's just, yeah, move on. No, I don't know, but I hope that sorted some of it out.
You can take the hat off.
No, I have to
wait
until the ad break.
What the whole... On-